The Deputy Inspector General of Government, Antoine Omugisha Muhaiwe, has said she will have Wakiso District health workers abscond from duty and those involved in stealing medicines from the government facilities arrested. Muhaiwe issued the warning in a meeting at Wakiso Town Council with district health officers in the presence of Malinga Alfred, the Chief Administrative Officer, Justin Babazi, the Wakiso RDC, and District Health Officer Emmanuel Mukisa. Muhaiwe said the meeting followed abrupt visits made by the Inspector General of Government in different health facilities.
Spot checks, Kachiri Health Center, Nendara Health Centers,
which found many health workers absent and those on duty mistreated the patients. She said that in the ongoing efforts to fight corruption, nobody will be spared. Muhaiwe noted that it is shocking that most government health facilities ask for money from patients to offer them treatment. She urged the health personnel to change their attitude to avoid the consequences. Malinga expressed disappointment at the actions of the health workers, saying that after enhancing their salaries, the quality of their services dwindled.
We are also aware that the government has not taken lightly issues of health. Many years they have been on the streets, demonstrating, and so and many things happened. Government has only listened, and we as civil servants, we've been always on their side. And I think where we are now, Madam Deputy President, government has done all it takes.
However, the District Health Officer, Emmanuel Mukisa, urged the government to increase the medicine allocated to Wakiso District Health facilities. He also reiterated the warning to medical staff for extort money from patients, saying this is a crime. Security organs in Imbale City have conducted a joint operation against consumers of shisha and narcotics. Operations that were carried out in Embassy Lounge, Club, El Tangia and Rooftop led to 18 being arrested.
We're able to get hold of a number of suspects who were caught in the act of smoking cigarettes directly, shisha. Others were smoking cigarettes, we are preparing the shisha pots, and we got all those suspects, and as we talk now, they are at CPS Bali.
Dr. Moses Mogonyi, the city health officer who led the operations, highlighted the dangers of using narcotics. Elgon Region Police Community Liaison Officer Zainab Namuyindi relayed details of the arrested and the exhibits in their possession. She expressed concern over the young people involved in drug abuse.
To have the nature of it, to never hear the workers. Ngen songa ya vude kuban yu a cigar aban yu ebida gala la gala. Fena tu chimanyi ti ebida gala gala binu biko so bongo bongo. Era wali wane teka ya bafrumi ya titokidis wafunyo era muchi mubani.
U.S. President Joe Biden sought to calm a divided nation Sunday after his rival Donald Trump survived an assassination bid, saying in a rare Oval Office address that it was time to lower the temperature of America's hostile politics. As the country reeled from images of a bloody Trump waving his fist after the gunman opened fire at a campaign rally in Pennsylvania, Biden added that U.S. politics must never be a literal battlefield, God forbid a killing field. The 20-year-old shooter, Thomas Matthew Crooks, was shot dead by Secret Service agents amid scenes of chaos. Authorities say his motive remains unclear. The FBI said it was investigating the attack as a potential act of domestic terrorism and studying Crooks' phone to discover any ideologies he may have had.
Yesterday's shooting at Donald Trump's rally in Pennsylvania calls on all of us to take a step back. Take stock of where we are, how we go forward from here. Thankfully, former Trump is not seriously injured. I spoke with him last night. I'm grateful. He's doing well, and Jill and I keep him and his family in our prayers.
Biden, giving just the third Oval Office address of his presidency, also mentioned the January 6, 2021 Capitol attack by pro-Trump supporters as proof that the situation is getting out of hand. The attempt on Trump's life has opened a dark new chapter in an already polarized election rematch with Biden, who beat him in 2020. Despite the bitter enmity, both Biden and Trump called for calm after the most serious attack on a U.S. president or ex-president in more than four decades. Biden, who is behind in most polls, will meanwhile have to tone down the full-throated criticisms of Trump that he pivoted to last week to shift attention from his own words.